Hi, my name is Kristin Roberts, and I am a full-time professor in Computer Information Systems at Grand Rapids Community College. My CO127 C++ programming course was recognized as a 2014 Blackboard Catalyst Award for Exemplary courses. I would like to give you a short demo of my course and what makes it exemplary. My course is ADA, American with Disability Act of 1990 compliant, and UDL, Universal Design for Learning compliant. The course is written in HTML5 and CSS3. The course uses headings H3, H4, and H5 to format documents. Headings allow for easy readability and navigation for all students, including those that may be using screen readers such as JAWS. All tables use HTML, T-head tags, and TH tags to mark column headings. Tables use the HTML summary attribute to describe what is in the table for the students using screen readers. This course starts out with a welcome announcement by the instructor, which uses an avatar, which is a Web 2.0 technology. The avatar is used to greet the online students. The avatar directs the students to the course tour menu link. The course tour covers how the class is laid out. Including a diagram of how the class is laid out. Course information shows the students that the syllabus, book, schedule, academic honesty, grading rubric, and career coach are listed there. Under assignments, it shows that it's divided by week 1, 2, 3. Each week has an overview with learning outcomes, PowerPoint and videos, assignment, and a submit assignment area. There are also course links that take you back to different areas and move you through the course. As you continue down the course tour, I give you a more in-depth view of the overview area for each week so that students know what is required activities and what are optional activities. And I also give them a diagram of how that area is laid out in a little more detail so that they realize they will have 3 assignments during each course week and they have a practice and a quiz for credit. Then I go on to etiquette expectations for the course. I add an extra etiquette expectation with earbuds. I talk about email for the course and how to forward your email, my instructor email, why I use my own email so I can color code responses, technical support, readiness quiz, and other readiness requirements. At the bottom of the course tour area is a course tour link to take the students to the next location on the course tour. The course tour winds through accessibility, which tells you about accessibility for the course, how to copy and paste things, how to increase your font size for easier readability, and then from there it goes on to connectivity. Connectivity talks about mobile preferences if you want to access the course through your iPhone and Blackboard Instant Messenger. From there, we go on to the course syllabus. The syllabus tells you information about the course and about all the requirements for the course, all the course policies, and then ends up telling you about the college policies. From there, you go to the schedule, also located in course information. The schedule has a breakout of all the assignments, tells you what the assignment numbers mean, has the assignments numbers listed by week, and points, and total points in the class. From there you go to the book to find out book information, where I have an image of the textbook. Required data files, the students can get all the files here or they can get them by week. Information on DreamSpark, where they can get a free download of the Visual Studio compiler for this class. Journey Ed, which is an optional option if they want to get some software from Journey Ed at educational prices. And then we move to academic honesty. Tells the students that they must do all their own work and a few other details about being academically honest. From there we go to the grading rubrics. The grading rubrics, I have grading rubrics outlining what the requirements for the discussion board, programming assignments, and the final project. I also have a resubmit policy listed there so that if they submit their assignment in on time and they do not get full credit, they have an opportunity to fix and resubmit. From there, we go to the assignment area. The assignment area is where they spend most of their time. This is the end of the course tour. Some information on what they need to do next. The course is divided into 14 folders that are located in the assignment area. Each folder represents a week of the course with due dates listed in the folder name. Assignment due dates are also displayed for the students in the View Grades location. Each weekly folder uses a consistent layout of 5 locations to chunk material into manageable segments. The weekly audio clip and transcript, the overview area with the learner outcomes, PowerPoint and video area, assignment area, and the submit assignment area. Course links are used to make navigation intuitive. Each week uses consistent navigations links, like back to the weekly assignment list. If I click on assignments, I have go to submit assignments, and inside of each assignment, I also have a go to submit assignment, back to assignment, or go to overview. In the submit assignment area, I have a just for fun icebreaker so that they can relax and have something else to think about while they're submitting their programs. After they submit the first program, if they want to see the second program, they can go back to the assignment area directly using the link, or they can finish the quiz. And the quiz has a practice quiz and a quiz for credit, or you can again go back to the assignment area or back to the overview area. FAQ is not on the course tour. However, it is an important area which answers questions on how to get the avatar and audio clips to play, gives programming tips, compiler tips, and gives answers to other commonly asked questions in the course. Didn't add this to the course tour as most students know what FAQs are. Instructor information is not on the course tour. However, it is also an important area that informs students of the instructor's office hours, feedback and response times for grading, approach to teaching, teaching philosophy, and a few other teaching strategies. There is also a link to the instructor personal web page if students want to find out more about their instructor. This course ends with the final project that pulls together all programming knowledge learned in the course. The final project is a president's program where the program gives you a president name and the user must identify the president number. For example, George Washington, president number 1, and Barack Obama, president number 44. If the student writes the program correctly, when the user gets correct answers, all the president information is read in from a vector, which was originally read in from a database when the program was executed. The president's name, time in office, vice president, and a few other pertinent information about the president is displayed. Once the president's number is given correctly, the president is removed from the vector. If the president's number is given incorrectly, the program replies that that was an incorrect response, and the president is left in the vector for another opportunity to be selected. The program keeps track of the right and wrong guesses, uses DOS console colors, and ends if the user requests to leave the program. The final project has its own FAQs and an icebreaker in this location with an image of a presidential car. The FAQs cover information from the grading rubric, how to read in data files, auxiliary functions, which was covered briefly in the course, and a few other important things to make the program work. I hope you enjoyed the tour as much as I enjoyed making it and the exemplary course. Best wishes for all. If you have any questions, please feel free to email me at karobert@grcc.edu. Thanks for listening.